Dr. Shweta Lahare. I'm the assistant professor of pharmacy department in the Anantrao Kanse Medical College and Hospital, Ayurveda. Today we will discuss one of the important chapter of the pharmacy, that is doctrine of signature. Doctrine of signature means if we are comparing physical properties of the plant with the signs and symptoms of the patient. It is one of the source of Maitreya Medica. The certain examples of the doctrine of signature are here. The first one is Pulsanilla. Now we will discuss the physical appearance of Pulsanilla plant with that of the signs and symptoms of the patient. Externally, the plant grows in desert and hence the patient is always having dry mouth. Plant requires less amount of water and the patient is thirstless. The flowers of the plant is always drooping. So, the patient is always shy in nature. The flowers of the plant are always in a bunch. That means the patient wants company. The patient do not want to be left alone. The flower changes its direction whenever there is a wind. And hence the patient is having the changeability. The pain or any complaint of the Pulsanilla patient always changes. So these are the doctrine of signature of Pulsanilla plant. Second example is of Lachesis, which is of animal origin. The external characteristics of Lachesis are the snake always protrudes its tongue and hence the patient is always open his mouth and it protrudes his tongue. With that, there is a drooping of tongue and the patient is always a loquacious patient. It is said that the snake is very much revengeful and the same complaint we can observe in the patient that the patient is always the revengeful mood. The snake always comes out in the spring and hence the symptoms of the patient is always aggravated in the spring season. It is said that the stool of the snake is always black and it is very offensive. Similarly, the discharges of the snake are dark and offensive. The movement of the snake is in a zigzag manner. So, the thinking of the patient is zigzag manner. The patient never thinks in a straight way. These are the doctrine of signature of the Lachesis. The third one is again of vegetable origin, that is a carpovich. We know it as a coal. The color of the coal is black. The patient is look like a bluish or blackish. When we burn the coal, it requires the wind from a near distance. Similarly, the patient always wants the fanning from near distance. The ash, it is looks like cold externally, but internally it is very hot. The patient is always, the same condition is with the patient. Patient is externally cold, but heat is present internally. Whenever we burn the coal, the fumes goes up and hence the patient is always having the distension, a flatulence in the upper part of the abdomen. So these are the doctrine of signature of carpovich. Similar doctrine of signature is present in the belladonna. The belladonna is grown where the soil is rich in the calcium carbonate and hence the belladonna and the calcareata, they are complement to each other. The next example is thuja. It is an antipsychotic remedy. The thuja is well known for the wart complaint because whenever there is a junction of branches or the stain, there is a pedunculated growth in the thuja patient and hence it is useful for the warts. The next example is of calcareata. The calcarea is having the soft hard shell to cover the soft body and hence the calcarea patient is always required of protection. The next example is of gelsemium. The flowers of gelsemium are yellow in color and hence the gelsemium is useful in the jaundice like complaint. And the last example is tarantula, which is prepared from spider. The spider is very sensitive to the drumbeat and hence the patient is very sensitive. The patient do not want to listen music. So these we have seen the doctrine of signature with their certain examples. Thank you.